Okay, yeah.
Yes, sir. I have started, sir.
Okay, great. Yeah, I think we have started with the traveling salesman problem the other day. I think one question we have solved. So we'll solve a couple of problems today so that you can clear the complete steps. So before we start with the class, I just want to ask you one thing from the class. Can one of you please tell me what is the condition on which a traveling salesman problem is constructed? Can anybody please tell me what is the basis on which the traveling salesman problem is constructed? Anyone? Hello? Able to hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. What is the basis on which we constructed as a traveling salesman problem? What is the basis here? What is the principle on which it is governed?
So we can start from the starting point and we can like approach any of the points, but we have to cover all the points before we come to the initial points.
Correct. So the salesman is supposed to travel all the places starting from this headquarters or the starting, and he can cover all the places in any order. There is no restrictions as such, but he should be able to come back to the original place only after visiting all the places. This is the condition which has to be verified when you are traveling a problem on traveling salesman. So let me explain this concept once again with one more question or maybe two questions today. I think with that you should be able to understand the complete intricacies as far as assignment problem is concerned. Okay, so let me take a question and then I'll try to explain that. There are probably five places here, A, B, C, D, E, and obviously we know that since you are supposed to cover five places, even the column also will have the same value. So infinity, 4, 7, 3, and 4. B values are 4, infinity, 6, 3, 4. The C value is 7, 6, infinity, 7, 5. And the D value is 3, 3, 7, infinity, 7. And the E value is 4, 4, 5, 7, and infinity. Okay, now this is a question given. I think I've told you the other day very clearly.
Yes, Mr. Sir.
Yeah.
So we can't see the board properly, sir.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. I'll just make a fitting. 1 minute. Now is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. I think I've told very, very clearly the other day. Whenever you have a question on traveling salesman problem, usually they will not give a separate question or a separate mention as far as traveling salesman problem is concerned. By looking at the nature of the data, you should be in a position to distinguish a regular assignment problem from that of a traveling salesman problem. Now, how do you distinguish a regular assignment problem from a traveling salesman problem? I think I've given a very important clue the other day. Can anybody please tell me how do we distinguish a traveling salesman problem from a regular assignment problem? How do we distinguish?
In traveling problem, there will be a...
Yeah, go ahead.
In traveling problem, there will be a infinity or dash symbol, sir.
Yeah, correct. See, whenever you have a question on traveling salesman problem, all the element that appears on the diagonal axis, I think I've told you very clearly the other day, whenever we have any matrix, the matrix has basically two different diagonal axes. One is called as the principal diagonal axis, and second one is called as secondary diagonal axis. A principal diagonal axis are those elements which starts from left to top and runs up to right bottom. Left to top in the right bottom are n elements. Adana we call it as principal diagonal axis. Right? So any elements on the principal diagonal axis, if it becomes an infinity or if it is just dash, then that indicates that it is a traveling salesman problem. That is a very, mechanical view of actually distinguishing. But if you were to understand the actual meaning of this infinity, it only suggests that it is impossible to travel from one place to other place if it's the same route. You cannot travel from A to A. You cannot travel from B to B. You cannot travel from C to C. So in order to restrict that particular option, they are all denoted by infinity. That is one very important clue or important factor that you have to look out when a question is asked in the exam. Otherwise, the question will be very simple. They will be asked, find the assignment cost for the following data. They will not give any other clue there. By looking at the nature of the data, you should be in a position to distinguish whether it is regular assignment problem or traveling salesman problem. That is one thing. Okay. Important condition in traveling salesman is the traveling salesman problem is entirely solved. Same thing with respect of Hungarian assignment method. Only in the we are supposed to verify the condition of traveling salesman. Otherwise, all other conditions are exactly same. When you are solving the problem of traveling salesman, the word or the number infinity becomes absolutely neutral. We are not supposed to apply any of the mathematical operations on infinity. Infinity can have other mathematical operations na apply madala. When you take row subtraction, column subtraction, or when you are trying to calculate optimal change, infinity will remain infinity till end of the question. That is something which you have to understand as far as this problem is concerned. Okay, I think this is the background which I wanted to give you. So before we start, something in traveling salesman problem is, in all traveling salesman problems, you will always get a balanced, nimge unbalanced problem barala. Always in traveling salesman problem, the question will be balanced, and therefore you can directly start solving with the row subtraction. Okay, so shall we start solving the problem now? Okay, so let's start now. So step number one. What is step number one? We are supposed to identify the lowest value in each row and subtract the entire row from that particular element. If you look at the first row, the lowest element is 3. So what is the answer now? Infinity will remain as it is, absolutely no change. So this becomes 1, this becomes 4, this becomes 0, and this becomes 1. Now let's come back to the second row. In the second row, the lowest value is again 3. So the values will become 1. Okay, coming to the third row, the lowest value is 5. So the value will become 2, 1, infinity, 2, and 0. And in the fourth row, the lowest value is 3. So therefore, the answer will become 0, 0, 4, infinity, and 4. And coming to the last row, the lowest value is again 4. So the value will become 0, 0, 1, and this is 3, and this is infinity. Now we have got the first step, which is called as the row subtraction. So after the row subtraction, the next step is column subtraction. So before we go for the column subtraction, let us see, are there at least one zero in each column? All the columns are zero except the third one. In the third column, since the lowest value is 1, obviously the value will change. So let's write down this again. Once again, so the third, the column subtraction. So identify the lowest value in each. Lowest value changes here. So this becomes 1, 2, 0, and 0. If you come to the second column, the lowest value is 0, therefore no changes. 1, infinity, 1, 0, 0. If you come to the third column, the lowest value is 1. So therefore, the value will become 3, and this becomes 2, infinity, 3, and this is 0. Fourth column, no change because 0 is there. And even in the fifth column also, no change because the 0 is there. So 1, 1, 0, 4, and infinity. Now we have successfully completed both row subtraction as well as column subtraction. Now after row and column subtraction, can you please tell me what is the next step? What are we supposed to do now?
Test for optimality.
Test for optimality. Very good. So you are supposed to test for optimality. What is test for optimality? You are supposed to draw minimum number of vertical or horizontal lines to cover all the zeros in the Meduse matrix. Now, can you please tell me how many lines are required to cover all the zeros in this matrix? Can you please give me a try? Just give a try and tell me.
Four, sir.
How many
four,
lines
four,
are
required? Four, sir. In fourth row, sir.
Four.
Column, sir. Last number is 4. You have written 0.
Yes, the last number is 3, right? 3. Correct. You're right. Yeah. So now can you please tell me how many lines are supposed to be drawn to cover all this?
4, sir.
4.
4.
Okay. This is the five. Which is tell me? I think we can go with the last row because there are only 3 zeros. This is the first line. And then maybe we can take the column number 4 because there are 2 zeros over here. Then we can take row number 4 because 2 zeros. And finally, we'll take one more column here. So now you can see that with 4 lines, we are able to cover all the zeros. So therefore, what does it mean now? It means the value of capital N equals to 4 and the value of small n equals to 5. This implies it is not an optimal solution. It is not an optimal solution, and therefore we are supposed to improvise the problem. I hope you all understand and remember how do we convert a non-optimal solution to optimal solution. There are totally 4 steps to be followed. Can one of you please quickly tell me which are the 4 steps to be followed to convert non-optimal to optimal? What is
identify the smallest uncovered element.
Very good. Next.
It should be subtracted by all other uncovered element.
Very good. Step number 3.
Add that smallest element which lies in intersection.
Very good. Okay. And the last one?
Covered element should be same.
Excellent. So as she rightly said, first identify the lowest uncovered element. So can you please tell me which is the lowest uncovered element in the entire matrix? I think 1 is the lowest uncovered element. All the uncovered elements should be subtracted by 1. So let me start writing the value. And please remember, we are not supposed to apply any mathematical operations on the infinity. Adu intersectionally, enadru agli, we are not supposed to do anything. The infinity will remain as infinity till the end. We are not supposed to do any calculations or any modifications to infinity. Please bear this thing in mind very clearly. So infinity will remain as it is anywhere. The second value will become 0. The next value will become 1. Then it is 0 and it is 0 again. Now we'll come back to the second column. In second column, can you please set the values now? The first value will become 0. The second value infinity will remain as it is. The third value will become 0. This is 0 again. And again, this is 0. Now coming to the lowest value, obviously, it can change like that. So this will become 1. And this will, sorry, this will become 2. This will become 1. This is. And coming to the fourth column, so this will remain unchanged, 0, 0, 2. Although this lies on the point of intersection, since it's infinity, we are not supposed to do any mathematical operation. It will remain at infinity as it is. But again, we have one more value which is lying on point of intersection 3. Here the value has to be added, so this becomes 4. Okay? Now coming to the last column. In the last column, what are the values we get? We get 1. Again, this is 1. And this is 0. Again, this is point of intersection. It is 4. So 4 plus 1 becomes 5. And finally, infinity. It remains same. No changes. So this becomes infinity. Now this is the next matrix that we have got after converting it. Okay. Can you please tell me how many lines are required to cover all the zeros?
5.
Still, we are able to draw 4 lines, or only 5 is possible?
5, sir.
Okay. Are you all sure? Are you all sure that it is not possible to draw less than 5 lines?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
If you are 100% sure that this is not possible to draw less than 5 lines, then I can directly write down. So n is equal to 5 and n also equal to 5. Therefore, it is optimal solution. As you all remember, I can go for allocation only once the condition of optimality is satisfied. Until the condition of optimality is satisfied, you are not supposed to do allocations. Now that the values are already equal, that is the optimality condition is satisfied. Now I think we can go for allocation. Ega allocation maadabodu. Okay, let's start with the allocation. Okay, we know that there are totally 5 values. Ile allocation maadabodu. We can go and take here. So A, B, C, D is the 5 pair. Again, A, B, C, D is the 5 pair. As usual, you all understand, you all remember the rule of allocation. Always the allocation shall be done row wise. Number 1. And number 2, always start the allocation from a row which has got single zero. Single zero yav row nal irutha, ಅಲ್ಲಿಂದ ನೀವು ಅಲೋಕೇಶನ್ ಶುರು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯು ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಟೆಲ್ ಮೀ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಎನಿ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಜೀರೋಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಮ್ಯಾಟ್ರಿಕ್ಸ್? ಸಿಂಗಲ್
ಜೀರೋ? ನೋ ಸರ್.
ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ನೋ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಜೀರೋಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಸೊ ಆಬ್ವಿಯಸ್ಲಿ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಎನಿ ರೋ ನೌ, ಯಾಕಂದ್ರೆ ಎಲ್ಲೂ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಜೀರೋ ಇಲ್ಲ. ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ರೋ ಇಟ್ಸೆಲ್ಫ್. ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಯು ದಿ ಅದರ್ ಡೇ, ಇನ್ಸ್ಟೆಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಪ್ಲೈಯಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕರೆಸ್ಪಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ, ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ಆರ್ ಡೂ ದಿ ಅಲೋಕೇಶನ್ ವಿತ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಮೆಥಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ಲೆಟ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್. ಈಗ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಕಮ್ ಟು ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ರೋ, ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಟೂ ಜೀರೋಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಐದರ್ ಈ ಜೀರೋ ಅಲೋಕೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಅಥವಾ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಟು ಅಲೋಕೇಶನ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಜೀರೋ. ನೌ ಐ ಶುಡ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಅ ಡಿಸಿಷನ್ ವೆದರ್ ಐ ಶುಡ್ ಗೋ ಫಾರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಜೀರೋ ಆರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಜೀರೋ. ಅದು ಹೇಗೆ ನೀವು ಅದನ್ನ ಡಿಸೈಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಾ? ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಸೀ ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ಜೀರೋಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಕಾಲಮ್. ಈ ಕಾಲಮ್ ನೀವು ತಗೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಕನೆಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಜೀರೋ ಫಾರ್ ಅಲೋಕೇಶನ್, ಸೀ ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ಜೀರೋಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಕಾಲಮ್. ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೀ ದಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ 3 ಕಾಲಮ್ಸ್. ದ ರೂಲ್ ಸೇಸ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಸಪೋಸ್ ಟು ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಎ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ಫಾರ್ ಅಲೋಕೇಶನ್ ಸಚ್ ಎ ವೇ ದಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ ರೂಲ್ ಔಟ್ ದಿ ಆಪರ್ಚುನಿಟಿ ಫಾರ್ ಅದರ್ ರೋಸ್ ಟು ಗೆಟ್ ಅಲೋಕೇಟೆಡ್. ನೀವು ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಅದನ್ನ ಅಲೋಕೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಬೇರೆ ರೋಸ್ ಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಅಲೋಕೇಶನ್ ಸ್ಕೋಪ್ ಇರಬೇಕು. ದೇರ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಎ ಸ್ಕೋಪ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅಲೋಕೇಶನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಶುಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ನಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವಾಯ್ಡ್. ಅಟ್ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ 1-0 ಅನ್ನೋರು ಉಳಿಬೇಕು. ಇಫ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್, ದಿಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬ್ಲಾಕ್, ಬಟ್ ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ 1-0 ಇದೆ, ಸೊ ನೋ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್. ಇಫ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಬ್ಲಾಕಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್, ಅಗೇನ್ 1-0 ಇದೆ, ನೋ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್. ಇಫ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್, ಅಗೇನ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ 2-0s. ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಆಲ್ ದಿ 3 ರೋಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ದೇರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಅಟ್ ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ 1 ಎಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಾ ಜೀರೋ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ರೋ, ವಿಚ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ ದಟ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ರೋ ಆಪರ್ಚುನಿಟಿ ಫಾರ್ ಅಲೋಕೇಶನ್. ಅದನ್ನ ವೆರಿಫೈ ಮಾಡಿ. ಆರ್ ಯು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್? ಓಕೆ, ಸಿಮಿಲರ್ಲಿ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ಅಪ್ ದಿಸ್ ಡಿ ಅಂತ ತಗೊಂಡ್ರೆ ನೀವು ಎರಡನ್ನ ಕಂಪೇರ್ ಮಾಡಿ, ಯು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಸೀ ಯಾವ ಕಾಲಮ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಮಿನಿಮಮ್ ಜೀರೋಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಥವಾ ಬ್ಲಾಕ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಅದನ್ನ ನೀವು ತಗೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಯಾವಾಗ್ಲೂ ಬೆಟರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇಫ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಜೀರೋ, 3 zeros ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಗೆಟ್ಸ್ ಬ್ಲಾಕ್, ಬಟ್ ಇಫ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಜೀರೋ, ಓನ್ಲಿ 1-0 ಗೆಟ್ಸ್ ಬ್ಲಾಕ್. ಆಲ್ರೈಟ್, ಸೊ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಬೆಟರ್ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ದಟ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ವೇರ್ ದ ಮಿನಿಮಮ್ ಜೀರೋಸ್ ಆರ್ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಬ್ಲಾಕ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಬೆಟರ್. ಐ ಹೋಪ್ ಯು ಆಲ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್. ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗ್ತಿದೆಯಾ ಅದು? ಆರ್ ಯು ಆಲ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಫಾಲೋ ದಿಸ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್?
ಯಸ್ ಸರ್.
ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ ಮೀ ಟೇಕ್ ಡಿ. ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಡಿ, ಇದನ್ನ ತಗೊಂಡ್ರೆ ಆಲ್ ಜೀರೋಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಕಾಲಮ್ ಗೆಟ್ಸ್ ಬ್ಲಾಕ್. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ 1-0 ಇದೆ, ಇಟ್ ಬ್ಲಾಕ್. ಯೂಶಲಿ ವೆನ್ ಎವರ್ ವಿ ಡೂ 1 ಅಲೋಕೇಶನ್, ಆಟೋಮ್ಯಾಟಿಕಲಿ 1 or 2 ರೋ ವಿಲ್ ಡೆಫಿನೆಟ್ಲಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಜೀರೋ. ಅದು ಕಾಮನ್ ಆಗಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ನೌ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯು ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಟೆಲ್ ಮೀ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಎನಿ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಜೀರೋಸ್ ಇನ್ ಎನಿ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ರೋಸ್ ನೌ?
ಬಿ ಸರ್,
ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ರೋ, ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್
ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಜೀರೋ. ಓಕೆ, ಇಫ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಬಿ ಎ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಜೀರೋ, ಆಬ್ವಿಯಸ್ಲಿ ಆಲ್ ದಿ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಕಾಲಮ್ ಬ್ಲಾಕ್. ಎನಲ್ಲಿ ಏನೇನು ಜೀರೋಸ್ ಇದೆ ಅದನ್ನ ಬ್ಲಾಕ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಸೊ ಇದು ಬ್ಲಾಕ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ಇದು ಬ್ಲಾಕ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ, ನೌ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯು ಸೀ ಎನಿ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಜೀರೋಸ್ ದೇರ್? ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಎನಿ ಸಿಂಗಲ್ ಜೀರೋಸ್? ನೋ. ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಇನ್ ಆಲ್ ಅದರ್ ರೋಸ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ 2 zeros ನೌ. ಓಕೆ, ಲೆಟ್ ಮೀ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಥರ್ಡ್ ರೋ. ಈಗ ಥರ್ಡ್ ರೋ ಅಲ್ಲಿ 2 zeros, ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ 1-0 ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅದರ್ ಜೀರೋ. ನೌ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ಅ ಕಾಲ್, ಶುಡ್ ಐ ಅಲೋಕೇಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಜೀರೋ ಆರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಜೀರೋ? ಒಂದ್ ವೇಳೆ ಈ ಜೀರೋ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ 2 zeros ಗೆಟ್ಸ್ ಬ್ಲಾಕ್. ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಅದರ್ ಜೀರೋ ಟು ಬಿ ಬ್ಲಾಕ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಬೆಟರ್ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ದಟ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂ ವೇರ್ ದ ನಂಬರ್ ಆಫ್ ಜೀರೋಸ್ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಬ್ಲಾಕ್ ಐದರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮಿನಿಮಮ್ ಆರ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್. ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗ್ತಿದ್ಯಾ? ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಮೇಕ್ ಅ ಕಂಪ್ಯಾರಿಸನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಹೌ ಮೆನಿ ಜೀರೋಸ್ ಗೆಟ್ಸ್ ಬ್ಲಾಕ್ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಎ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಜೀರೋ. ನಾನು ಈ ಜೀರೋನ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ 3 zeros ಬ್ಲಾಕ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಇದು ಬ್ಲಾಕ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಇದು ಬ್ಲಾಕ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಇದು ಬ್ಲಾಕ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಬಟ್ ಇಫ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಜೀರೋ, ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಅದರ್ ಜೀರೋ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಬ್ಲಾಕ್. ಸೊ ಇನ್ವೇರಿಯಬಲಿ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಬೆಟರ್ ಚಾಯ್ಸ್. ಇದನ್ನ ತಗೊಂಡು if I'm taking this, then obviously there is no other zero getting blocked. Okay? Now we'll come back to the fourth. Your fourth is the one, right? You have single zero. Now, if I'm taking this, obviously a little block agata. If I'm taking this, this is getting blocked, this is getting blocked, and this is getting blocked. Okay? Ella muru block aayitu. And at the same time, it is still giving an opportunity for the last row to have allocation. It is not killing the opportunity of fifth row. That is very, very important. ಒಂದ್ ವೇಳೆ ಆ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ರೋ ನಲ್ಲಿರೋ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಜೀರೋ ಬ್ಲಾಕ್ ಆಗ್ಬಿಟ್ರೆ ದೆನ್ ಆಬ್ವಿಯಸ್ಲಿ ಯುವರ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಗಿವ್ ಎನಿ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್. ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಇಂಪ್ರೂವೈಸ್ ಫರ್ದರ್. ಸಿನ್ಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ 1 more zero ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ರೋ, ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಗೋ ಫಾರ್ ಅಲೋಕೇಶನ್. ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ನೌ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ದಟ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ವೆರಿಫೈ ವೆದರ್ ಮೈ ಅಲೋಕೇಶನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್. ಹೌ ಡು ಐ ವೆರಿಫೈ ದಟ್? ವೆರಿ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೀಜರ್. see whether every single row and every single column has an allocation. Prati row mate prati column nalli one allocation irlebeku. If all rows and columns has an allocation, then we can conclude that my allocations are correct. You can see allocation is 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All five rows and five columns has an allocation. Now the allocation is complete. Is there any doubt in this step? Yaragaru doubt idiya adralli? Any doubts with this particular step? Anybody?
No, sir.
Okay. If you are clear, okay. Now I think we have done with the allocation. I think this is exactly same. Illi varage, it is Hungarian assignment method. We have done absolutely no changes here. Up to here, it is a regular assignment problem. Now, traveling salesman problem comes into picture. Now, what is traveling salesman problem say? The traveling salesman problem asks you a separate condition or an extra condition. What is that extra condition? The extra condition is that the person should start his journey from A, visit all the other places, and then finally he should come back again to A. Aa condition no nimma traveling alli achieve aagidya athwa illwa anta verify madbeku. That is something which has to be verified. Okay, so let us see whether the condition is satisfied or not in this problem. First let us write down the allocation first. Hey, allocation parikura like this. A has traveled to B. A is the day home. Again, the B has traveled to A. A home. C has traveled to E. Okay, and then the D has traveled to B. Okay, and finally the person E or city E has traveled to C. This is the total travel history. A is itara barkobeku. You are supposed to write down this very clearly. I'm just writing from where and where he has traveled. ನೋಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಎ ಟು ಡಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿ ಟು ಎ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಸಿ ಟು ಇ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಡಿ ಟು ಬಿ ಫೋರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇ ಟು ಸಿ ಇಸ್ ದ ಫಿಫ್ತ್ ಐ ಹವ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ರಿಟನ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಹೌ ದಿ ಅಲೋಕೇಶನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಡನ್ ನೌ ಹೌ ಡು ಐ ವೆರಿಫೈ ದ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಟ್ರಾವೆಲಿಂಗ್ ಸೇಲ್ಸ್ಮನ್ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಯೆಸ್ಟರ್ಡೇ ಹವ್ ಟಾಟ್ ಯು ದಟ್ ವೆರಿ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ಹೇಗೆ ವೆರಿಫೈ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಪೇರ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ರಿಟನ್ ಆಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಯಾವುದು ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಪೇರ್ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಎ ಟು ಡಿ ಎ ಟು ಡಿ ಇಸ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಪೇರ್ ಅದು ನಾಳೆ ಬರ್ತದೆ and then see the continuity you eat nikta malakandi d in the any hoptara from d the person is traveling to b so d is the b b is coming to a now you can see that the traveling salesman condition is it satisfied or not satisfied here
not satisfied sir.
Not why? Satisfied
why not it is satisfied. Not satisfied
Can anybody
yeah you can see that the person has come back without visiting two more cities andre innu erdu city no miss madidane yav city miss madidane city c and city e he has not covered but he has come back to a which is a clear violation of the traveling salesman condition artha aagtide nimge are you all able to follow how to verify the condition ekandre tumba jana they will solve till here but verifying the condition they'll mistake idana verify madralu tapp madkotare okay ee sequence adu appadukolli the first sequence is right you can see from a has traveled to b b has traveled to b and again has traveled to b which means that the traveling salesman condition is not satisfied andre this problem has to be further modified athwa further improvised idu elli varge improvise madbeku andre until we get the traveling salesman condition satisfied alli varge problem na continue madbeku problem na hege lengthy madabodu andre the number of iterations in the problem can be more like 5 6 7 steps agabodu kelavame within one step you might get the answer it all depends on the question there is science behind here or there is no specified you know a thumb rule or a simple rule to do it is just a patience test patience in the matter I think we'll get the answer so it's a very simple procedure okay now I think it's very clear that the traveling salesman condition is not satisfied I think if you all remember the other day I've told you one vela traveling salesman condition satisfy aglilla andre then what is the next step we are supposed to do what are we supposed to do the next can anybody please recollect what did we solve the other day tell me how do we proceed this question further
instead of single zero
yeah
instead of single zero we can select or start our journey by selecting any lowest number in the whole matrix.
Yeah, it is not any lowest value, it is the next lowest value. It's very, very important. Okay, you should always start your next allocation from a value which is next lowest after zero. Zero bit to next yavudide andre now technical agi heladadre next higher value tagolbeku. So obviously after zero in this entire matrix, one is the next higher value. Adre ill problem enandre there are totally four ones. Ill one ide there is a possibility of getting the answer out of this four one alli yavadadru one ge answer barudu, we don't know. Okay, I have to just give a try with all the four. In case if I'm getting the answer with the very first one, we'll stop there. Otherwise, we have to continue the problem further. Okay, so let's start now. Let's take a question. Same problem, same matrix. I'm just continuing the same matrix now. Okay, so the matrix I'm just writing here. Okay, so infinity 0, 2, 0, 1. Okay, are you all able to see the board clearly?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sorry? Can you see the board?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Oh, yeah. So 0, infinity, 1, 0, 1. Then we have 1, 0, infinity, 2, 0. Then we have 0, 0, 3, infinity and 5. And then 0, 0, 0, 4 and infinity. As I clearly said, the first path has to be changed. So instead of starting your allocation from zero, let me start allocation from higher value. Okay, can you see the board? Sorry, there was a call. Okay, yeah. Are you able to see the board, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Hello?
Yes, sir. Okay. Yes.
Okay. Now I'm supposed to start my allocation to 1. You totally have 4 ones in there. I can select from any one. Either I can take this, 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 or this. Okay, so let me start with the first one. First one, Togodana. Okay, if I'm selecting this one, if I'm taking this, then obviously all the zeros of that particular column has to be blocked. And please remember, the deviation in allocation is applicable only once. Onsali matra, I should be doing my allocation with other than zero. Once I've changed my path, then the remaining allocation shall continue with zero only. Please remember this very carefully. And matte tiriga one tagola avashyakata illa. Only in the first time I'm changing the path. Once the path is changed, then you can continue the question with the same zero. Same zero allocation is a continue manner. Now the problem remains exactly same as the previous case. Okay. I think now we have got the first allocation done in the first row. Now same procedure, search for single zeros. Are there any single zeros in the entire problem remaining valuationally?
Third row.
Third row.
Yeah, we have a zero, third row. Yeah, correct. Third row is single zero. Yeah? So if I'm selecting this, then all the zeros of that particular column gets blocked. You block up there, you block up. Now do we have any single zero?
Fourth row.
We have a zero in the fourth, very good. So if you take this, this is also gets blocked and this also gets blocked. So do we have any single zero now? Yes, we have a single zero in the fifth row. It is the contract, we have the zero still. And finally, you have a single zero in the second row. So if I'm taking this, this gets blocked. Now you can see that the allocation is completed. First row, second row, third, fourth, fifth, first, second, third, fourth, fifth, all five rows and five column as allocations. So allocation is completed. Now let us verify whether our allocation is correct or not. Okay, whether the condition is traveling condition is satisfied or not. Let me verify. So obviously from A, he has traveled to E. A to E. B, he has traveled to D. Okay, and from C he has traveled to B. Okay, and from D he has traveled to A. Okay, and again from E he has C. Okay, now this is what the condition. Please tell me the variable. How do we verify? supposed to keep note as it is. Okay, from E where is he going? He's going to C. From C where is he going? He's going to D. E where is he going? He's going to D. From D, he's coming. Now you can see that the traveling salesman condition is satisfied because he has visited all the four places before he has come back to A. Arthayita largo? Have you all followed this step? Everyone?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Once this traveling salesman condition is satisfied, then I can go for calculating the cost. And please remember, the cost shall be calculated only after the traveling salesman condition is satisfied. Now, traveling salesman condition satisfied, maadadana, you cost calculate maada avashyakata illa. You are not supposed to calculate. Right? The cost is imperative feature. Condition satisfied maadadmel matra, the cost has to be calculated. I think now the condition is satisfied, we can directly find the cost. Okay, cost heltira sulpa quick agi. Can you please look at the main values and tell me? Okay, illi nan sulpa. I'll just okay. Yeah, I think now you're able to see the main question also, no? Answer the ellarigu.
Yes, yeah. Sir.
Please tell me the values from A to E. What is the value? How much we get?
4.
B to D?
3.
C to B?
6.
6. And D to A?
3.
And E?
5.
Okay, everything, how much we get?
21.
And all the value, how much we get?
21, sir.
21, Bharata? Okay. So 8 plus 6, 14, 17, 21. So 21 rupees becomes your minimum assignment cost and the traveling salesman condition is satisfied. Okay? Now, have you got a fair idea about how to solve the traveling salesman problem, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Okay.
I think we'll solve one more last question on this. I think with that, you should be able to, you know, completely have an understanding about it. And I think that we'll be able to complete the assignment chapter also. So as far as assignment chapter is concerned, these are the only methods you have as far as your syllabus is concerned. The first, we started with Hungarian assignment method. And then we started solving problems on unbalanced problem, and then we solve problems on maximization case, and finally we have problems on traveling salesman. Okay, so I'll take one more question on traveling salesman. I think with that you should be able to have a fair idea about it, and I'll be posting some questions tonight on traveling salesman, and I urge everyone to please solve some problems on that so that you know you will have a clarity about how to solve the problems on traveling salesman. Okay, is that all okay with all of you? Can you solve some problems on that today? So that you'll be perfect.
Yes,
with this. Okay. Yes, let me take one more question, and I think with that we'll be able to end it. Okay. One more last question. Okay. Let's take a question. A, B, C, and D. Infinity, 41, 82, 40, second value is 46, infinity, 32 and 40, the third column is 16, 50, infinity, 36, and the fourth column is 40, 40, 60 and infinity. Okay? Yeah. I think now by looking at the question,
so it is not visible.
Yeah, I think now it's clear, I guess.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I think it will be autofocus. So anyway, this is what Rajat educated me on this. So don't worry about it, sir. The moment you start writing, automatically, you know, it becomes autofocus. Okay, I think anyway, it's clear now. Hmm? Yeah. Now, if you look at this question, it's very clear that it's a traveling salesman problem because all the elements on the principal diagram. This is one thing which should be very clear. As I said, some examiners use infinity as a symbol and few examiners may use just dash. Okay? You don't worry about the notations. Notations are not very important here. In case if that particular route is restricted, it means it's a traveling salesman problem. Right? It can be interchangeably used any notation. Kelur infinity use maadtara, kelur bari dash anta. So both conveys the same meaning. Okay? I think we'll just start with the question now. As usual, step number one, we're supposed to talk about the row subtraction. And I told you one thing very clearly, all traveling salesman problem will be balanced by default. It will always balance in given. Okay? So first row, the lowest value is 16. So this is infinity. Infinity A changes at it will remain as it is. So this will become 30, this will become 0, and this will become 24. Coming to the second row, in the second row, the lowest value is 40. So this becomes 1, this becomes infinity, this becomes 10, and this becomes 0. In the third row, the lowest value is 32. So this becomes 50, this becomes 0, this becomes infinity, and this becomes 28.
2, sir.
Yeah, and the last row, the lowest value is 36. So therefore, it is 4, 4, 0, and infinity. Let us see whether there is a single 0 in every column so that we can rewrite and write as it is. No, I think in the first column there is 1. Otherwise, it has to be rewritten. Okay, let me write it here. So the column subtraction will do it. Now the lowest value each column should be taken. In the first column, the lowest value is 1. So therefore, what happens now? Infinity, 0, 49, and this becomes 3. I think in all the other three columns, since there is 0, the value will remain as it is, no changes. So this is 30, infinity, 0, and 4. In the third column, no changes again. 0, 10, infinity, 0. And in the fourth column also no change. 28 and infinity. Okay. Yeah. Can you please tell me how many lines are required to cover all zeros? That is test for optimality. Can you please tell me how many lines are required?
Four.
With how many to cover all the zeros?
Yes, sir. Four.
Three. Sorry?
Three, sir.
Three lines.
Second row.
Okay, second row first. Then?
Second column, third column.
Second column and third column. Okay. Second column and third column. Yes. I think with three lines, we are able to cover all the zeros. Therefore, n is equals to 3 and n is equals to 4. Therefore, it is not optimal solution. It is not optimal solution. So, therefore, we are supposed to improvise this. How do we improvise the solution? I hope you all remember four steps. Identify the smallest uncovered element. Subtract all the uncovered element from that smallest value. Add the smallest uncovered element to point of intersection. And the remaining covered element remains as it is. These four steps have to be simultaneously done, and then we'll get a new matrix. Okay, so let's write the new matrix now. If you look at this entire table, the lowest uncovered element happens to be 3. So 3 is the lowest uncovered element. So infinity will remain as it is, 0 will remain as it is, 49 minus 3 is 46, and this is 0. Coming to the second column, 30 remains as it is, infinity remains as it is. 0 remains as it is, 4 remains as it is. Coming to the third column, again 0 remains same. 10 lies in the point of intersection, so therefore we are supposed to add 13 and infinity will remain as it is, and this is 0. And coming to the last column, the first value will be subtracted, so 21, the second value is 0, the third value becomes 25, and the fourth value will remain as it is, infinity. So this is a new matrix that we have got after checking the condition of optimality. Okay, can you please tell me how many lines now required? Can we still draw three lines or four lines are required?
Four lines.
Four.
Are you sure?
Four.
Is there anybody who can tell me still three lines are possible? Yes or no? Because drawing the lines are very, very important. In case if you make any mistake here, then the whole problem will go wrong. Is it four lines?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I think it is four lines, so we can directly write it now. N is equals to 4 and n is equals to 4. Therefore, it is optimal solution. So if it is optimal solution, then we can go for allocations. I hope you all remember by now, optimality has to be satisfied if you want to go for allocation. Without optimality test being done, I cannot go for allocations. Since it is satisfied, I can go for allocation. So A, B, C, D is the four places here which we are supposed to assign in the order. As usual, same procedure. We'll always start with a row with single zero right? I think we have a single zero in the first row. I can take it here. Then the zeros of that particular column is blocked. So it is gone. So now you can see there is a single zero in the last row, that is D. So if I'm taking this, this is gone. And now you can see there is a single zero in B, that is second row. If I'm taking it, there is nothing. And finally, there is a single zero here. So now you can see that all the four rows and four columns are allocated. A, B, C, D, all fours are allocated. Correct? You all able to see now? Okay. Now, let us see whether the traveling salesman condition is satisfied or not. Okay, let me write on the allocation first. A is allocated to C. B is allocated to D. C is allocated to B. And finally, the D is allocated to A. Okay? Are you all able to understand this? I have just written the allocation. Now let us check the condition of traveling salesman. As I said, the first pair should be written as it is. From A is traveling to C. And now you see in this matrix, from where C is going to go. From C, A is traveling to B. So from C, A is traveling to B. Now you see from B, where is it traveling? From B, A is traveling to D. And finally, from D, A is traveling to A. So it's a very simple question. In the very first instance, you have seen that the traveling salesman condition is satisfied. So it is not necessary that all the problems will have to be further revised. If you are lucky enough, you might get a question in the exam where you will get the answer in the very first step also. I think this is one such, where you have got the answer directly. You have to modify it because in the regular assignment itself, I think the traveling salesman condition is satisfied. So I think it is good to go. Now we can calculate the cost. So can you please tell me the cost now quickly? What is the cost?
16.
How much?
16.
Okay. How much? 40. 40. So B to D is change maintain. Okay. So B to D is 40.
Okay.
32. And B to A?
40.
Add all the four, how much we get?
128.
So 128 is the minimum assignment cost as far as this particular assignment is concerned. Arthaita, have you all understood now the condition or the problems on traveling salesman? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. You want some more questions to be solved or you are perfect with this method? You should tell me now. You want some more questions to be solved or are you okay with this? Solve my dear, I'll solve one more question. Sorry?
We have understood, sir.
Everyone? Okay. I think otherwise you can tell me. I don't mind solving one more question if you want. In case if you have understood, then I can stop. I'm okay with either of it. Okay? Yeah. So if you are understood and if you don't want me to solve any more questions, then I think I can stop at this stage. So I will be floating some questions today. Maybe you can just try those problems so that you will be able to understand the complete traveling salesman. And then in case the questions come in the exam, I think you should be able to solve the problem. Okay, so this completes the assignment problems. I think we have finished with the first part of module 5, which is assignment problem. And tomorrow we will start with a new chapter within module 5, which is called a sequencing problems. It's again entirely a different chapter altogether, but it is being combined with module 5 first time. Assignment go sequencing go enu sambandha illa. They are entirely two different chapters actually. Only while structuring the module, they have just combined. Otherwise, there is no connectivity and stuff like that. So it's an independent chapter. So we'll start from tomorrow. I hope that everybody has understood the entire concept of assignment perfectly. So can I assume that way that you all have understood all the three methods of assignment, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Just tell me which are the methods we solved in assignment problems. The first method is Hungarian assignment method. The second type of questions we solved was within Hungarian assignment method, we solved on unbalanced problems. And then we took questions on maximization case. I hope you all remember, in maximization case, we don't have a separate method. All that we are supposed to do in maximization cases, we will convert it to minimization case, solve the problem by Hungarian method. But finally, when you're writing the final answer, we will take the original value. That is the only difference here. It is exactly same as your transportation problem. But please remember one thing in assignment problem, that is in maximization case, you are supposed to convert a maximization problem to minimization problem. only after one way or the other. Sorry, there was a call. You are able to hear me? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
The call, that's why I couldn't take it. Anyway, yeah. So as far as maximization is concerned, first you have to convert it to minimization, and then you should supposed to be solving it. And finally, the last method in assignment problem is traveling salesman. Again, in the question paper, they will not make any mention about the method. By looking at the virtue of the question, you should be in a position to distinguish whether it is a traveling salesman problem or just a general assignment problem. That you have to distinguish. And how do we distinguish that? By looking at the symbol infinity or dash. That is the key indicators here. Okay. Yaude assignment question alli, the entire principal diagonal axis, if infinity dash anta kottidre, then we can conclude that the question belongs to traveling salesman. So the whole problem is exactly same as assignment, but only in the last step, the traveling salesman conditions to be verified. I think now you have understood how do we verify the traveling salesman condition. And I'm telling you again, in the entire assignment problem, no matter however you draw the line, whichever approach you follow, everybody must get the same answer. Transportation problem tara, nimge variable answers barala ille. That is one thing, please remember everyone. In the all four methods of assignment, everyone shall get the final answer at the same, irrespective of the number of steps. Number of steps, jaasti kadame agabodu, no problem. Few people might have got the answer within 2 step. Few people might have got after 4 step. That is all perfectly fine. Don't worry about it. But the final answer, everyone shall get the same. Illi uniformity idda iruthe. Hagagi don't have any confusion as far as the final answers is concerned. Everybody should get the same final answer because the answers are unique here. Clear? Is that clear, everyone? Have you all got a clear picture about assignment problems now? Everyone?
Yes, yes sir.
Yes. Yes.
I think we can stop the class for the day. So that is all from my end. And I think you've finished with assignments as well. So tomorrow we will start with a new chapter. And if possible, I'll try to post the question today itself on traveling salesman. Maybe you can practice some questions on that. And you can be submitting the assignments as per your convenience later. That will decide later. But questions I'll try to post. Okay? So thank you all. So have a nice day, and we'll meet tomorrow. So tomorrow class, I'll just post you. I'll just check with CR when you will be free. Accordingly, we will fix the timing. Okay? Yeah. So thank you
all. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you,
sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.